Good day, fellow investors. Invest for yourself, try to do better than the market, or simply invest in the market. That's the internal question. And can you beat the market? Well, Warren Buffett gave us an answer in 1984, as I think he got fed up of constantly answering that question. So he wrote the article, The Superinvestors of Graham and Doddsville, where he explained why he and his friends did beat the market, how it wasn't luck, and how you can do it too, if you are up for it. So we'll go through the article, discuss the comparison with coin flipping, where people, a lot of people think that stock market is just gambling, discuss what is investing, what is value investing, how it's applied, discuss the example, some of the examples that Warren puts in the article. You will be able to download this on my free stock market course, of which this is a part of, so you can read the whole article and enjoy it too. The link is in the description below. And then we'll explain risk versus reward when it comes to beating the market and conclude to see whether value investing is something for you or not. If you enjoyed this video, please smash that like button and consider subscribing if you haven't. So the article starts by discussing how if every American would flip a $1 coin, double or nothing, and do that over 20 days, at the end, we would have about 200 coin flipping millionaires that would go out and make books and courses, probably now YouTube channels about how they flipped the coin and became a millionaire. But that is purely luck and purely statistics. However, value investing is something else. And Warren Buffett goes through Ben Graham, his teachings, and how his disciples beat the market, did better than the market by having completely different strategies, which then beats the thesis, the academic thesis, that you can only beat the market by luck. He wrote this in 1984, and all his disciples did even better since. So they just kept doing what they did in the past, and they just kept doing it until now, and still did better than the market. So value investing and what Warren Buffett wants to show us is the things that work and that he wants to prove us it's not a flipping contest. And the core of it is that you search for discrepancies between the value of a business and the price of small pieces of that business in the market. So we look at businesses in general. What is that business worth from different perspectives, as you will see later, and compare that to the price of the business now, or just price of part of the business that we can buy on the stock market. If the value of the business is bigger than the price we have to pay, that's value investing. That's it. And now if we look at the value and price of a business, you can immediately see by looking at any stocks how the market is irrational. At some point, a business value can change 34% in just a few months. So what changed from here to here, only to then return to normal in the next months, then again up and down, and then boom, hugely up. If this is rational business valuing, then I don't know what rational is. But these ups and downs, and then we as value investors, we try to find, okay, what's the real value of the business for us, and then buy when we think that it is below the market value. That's about it. And you focus simply on two variables, price and value. Let's go through a few examples from the article. So first, I love really Walter Schloss. There is a lot of writing about him, so I might write a book about him because he is really one of the great investors out there. And he did about 21% over his 50 years, even better, but this is up to 1984, and he did destroy the market. How did he do that? He had no connections with Wall Street. He just read annual reports. He looked for a margin of safety principle. He was extremely diversified with more than 100 stocks, and he was looking at securities that sell at considerably less than their value to a private owner. And he simply says, if a business is worth a dollar and I can buy it for 40 cents, something good might happen to me. And he kept doing that also after 1984, and he just did much better than the S&P 500 until 2000 when he retired. This is a little bit misleading, the chart here, but from 1989 till 1997, I think it was 10 years, he just, let's say, tripled his portfolio, while the S&P 500 did much better. I think it was 6 times up. And people were calling him old-fashioned. People were saying, after 10 years of terrible performance compared to the market, were saying various things about him. Then, of course, the dot-com bubble burst. He doubled his money. The market crashed 50%. And then he retired as one of the best investors ever. Another example, Tweedy Brown, so 16-20%, also later till 2015, since 1993, also outperformed the benchmarks there. Then we had Buffett Partnership, 1984, he did 29%, a little bit lower since, but still on average 20%. Sequoia Fund, Bill Ruane, 18%, also just kept doing his thing for years and years after, and still did pretty much better than the S&P 500. And now, it's very important to understand that, as Buffett says, this group assumed much less risk than the market, because risk is defined in a different way here. Risk is, okay, how much can I lose if I buy a dollar for 50 cents? You can't lose. You invest with a margin of safety. If you just buy the market and you look at it going up and down, that's not risk, that is volatility. But academia have assumed that volatility is the best measure of risk because the market is always right. And as we see here, the market is not always right. As always, buy the business. Don't buy the stock. The stock goes up and down. The business is what drives your returns. And the key is, the lower the stock price is for a good business, the higher the return is. So investing here is low risk equals high reward, not high risk. And now it comes to whether this is something for you. We discussed in a recent video how Charlie Munger says you need a lot of time sitting on your ass and looking and working and going through numbers. And you have to see whether this value investing approach is something for you. And I simply say it either is or not. You can't turn from a gambler into a value investor. So I hope that by seeing this, you see whether value investing fits you or not. If yes, then subscribe. If not, well, there is plenty other things to do in life. So read the article. Please check my stock market research platform, because the price is going up by the end of the month. And that's what I do. I look for undervalued businesses, good businesses that will deliver good returns over time, no matter what the market does. Thanks.